In this series of videos, I want to talk about the comparison test, which is the subject of section 11.4 of Stewart's book, and the closely related limit comparison test. The limit comparison test is actually going to be maybe our most useful series convergence test out of all the different tests that we learn. We'll start first with the comparison test. So what does the comparison test say? So if we have two sequences, AN and BN, and they're both non-negative, and the BNs are always bigger than the ANs. If the sum of the BNs, the sum of the bigger things, converges, it converges to something less than infinity, then the sum of the ANs, the sum of the smaller things, converges also. That makes sense. I mean, you're adding up a bunch of numbers. If you add up the bigger numbers and you get something less than infinity, then when you add up the smaller numbers, you should also get something less than infinity. Okay. Similarly, if you have sequences AN and BN, ANs are smaller than the BNs and they're both non-negative, and the sum of the ANs goes off to infinity. You add up a bunch of the smaller numbers and you get something that goes off to infinity, then when you add up the bigger numbers, that sum goes off to infinity as well. So with this setup, 0 less than or equal to AN less than or equal to BN, if the sum of the BNs, the bigger numbers, converges, then the sum of the ANs, the smaller numbers, also converges. If the sum of the smaller numbers, the ANs, diverges, then the sum of the bigger numbers, the BNs, also diverges. So how are we going to use this test? This works really well for series where your sequence, the things you're adding up, have a sine or a cosine in them. So we'll see an example of that in a few minutes. And you have some sequence you want to know about, some series you want to know about, either this AN sum or this BN sum. And you need some related series to compare it to. Like for your ANs, you need some BNs. For your BNs, you need some ANs. So what kind of series are good to use for this comparison test? There are two classes of series that we understand really well, geometric series and P series. We know exactly when they converge and when they diverge, so they'll be really useful in applying the two different versions of this test. So I'm going to pause and erase, and then we'll see two examples of the comparison test in action. For our first example, let's look at the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of 1 plus cosine n over n squared. We're going to use the comparison test here, but how would you decide to use the comparison test? Well, this 1 plus cosine n in the numerator is a little tricky. But this is really close to something that we know really well, which is 1 over n squared, or like 1 plus 1 over n squared. 1 over n squared gives us a P series, something we understand really well. So here's the idea. The idea is cosine n, that's a function that flips back and forth in a crazy way, but we know that it's always at most 1, and it's at least minus 1. So that means that 1 plus cosine n is always at most 2 and at least 0, and 1 plus cosine n over n squared is always at most 2 over n squared and at least 0 over n squared, which is just 0. So now it looks like we're in the setup of the comparison test, where we let the thing that we care about be an, and this bigger set of numbers, 2 over n squared, be bn. So the comparison test is going to tell us something about when the ans converge in terms of the bns. So what do I mean? So we know that the sum of the bns, n equals 1, infinity, 2 over n squared, that's this sum of the bns. Well, this is 2 times the sum of 1 over, sorry, n equals 1 to infinity of 1 over n squared. Why is that true? Well, if this series converges, then you can factor out the 2 everywhere. And if it diverges, then we're going to get 2 times something that diverges. So this kind of algebraic distributive law thing is okay working with series. And we know that this converges. How do we know that? Because this is a P series with P equals 2. So remember, the P series converges for any P bigger than 1 and diverges when P is less than or equal to 1. So what does that mean? So we have this AN sequence and this BN sequence. And we saw that the sum of the BNs, the bigger things, converges. So by the comparison test, because the sum of the BNs converges, the sum from N equals 1 to infinity of the AN sequence, which is the sequence, the series that we care about, 1 plus cosine N over N squared, converges also. So just as a piece of notation, this less than infinity symbol means that it converges, but I'm just emphasizing what's going on here. So this is a really good example of the way that you can use the comparison test. And what I like about this example is it's very, very close to some things that we did when we talked about the convergence of sequences instead of convergence of series. So this isn't a totally new idea. It builds on what we've already seen for sequences. So I'll pause and erase and then do one more last example for this video. For our last example of this video, let's look at the sum from n equals 2 to infinity of 1 over natural log of n. First thing, this series starts at n equals 2 instead of n equals 1. Why is that? Because natural log of 1 is 0, so it wouldn't make sense to start this series at 1. So before just jumping into the comparison test, one question is why use the comparison test? And, well, we could say, what else could we try? We could say, compare to the integral from 2 to infinity of 1 over natural log of x dx, and try to use the integral test to say, well, this series is going to converge if this integral converges. But the problem is, this is not an integral that we know how to do. So if you don't believe me, try to do it. So we don't know how to do this integral. And this is common. The comparison test is going to allow us to tell whether a series converges or diverges in cases where if we tried to do the same thing using the integral test, we would get stuck with an integral we just don't know how to do. So what's the idea? So the idea is instead, we're not going to integrate 1 over natural log of x, but we're going to relate this 1 over natural log of x to something we know better. Well, how big is natural log of n? It's definitely less than or equal to n when we care about this sequence, which is for n greater than or equal to 2. So what does that mean? That means that 1 over natural log of n, if we have a smaller thing, then we take 1 over it and we get something bigger. It's greater than or equal to 1 over n for n greater than or equal to 2. And, okay, let me just say something about this. How do you know that this is true? Like, what do you have to say to justify something like this? Well, if you put in the smallest value, natural log of 2 is definitely less than 2. I mean, that we know. And then, how do you tell that if you have one function that's bigger than another function, how do you tell that it stays bigger as n gets bigger? Well, if you take natural log of x versus x, which one is growing faster when n is greater than or equal to 2? Well, how do you tell? You take the derivatives. The derivative of natural log of x is 1 over x, and the derivative of x is 1. So which one has a bigger derivative is 1 is bigger than 1 over x. So what does that mean? That means the function f of x equals x grows faster than g of x equals natural log of x. So this is a common kind of idea to see that one function is bigger than another. You find one value where your function is bigger, and then you just say the derivative is bigger, which means that this bigger function is always growing faster. Okay, but what's the idea here? Now, we have a bigger sequence, a smaller sequence, and they're both bigger than zero. So we'll call the bigger things bn's, and the smaller things an's. And we want to know about the bn's. But we know that the sum, fix this here, the sum from n equals 2 to infinity of 1 over n, well, what is this? This is the same as the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of 1 over n, but then we're missing the first term, minus 1 over 1. What do we know about this? This diverges. Why? Because this is a p-series with p equals 1. So, we have these an's and these bn's, and by the comparison test, the sum of the smaller things, the an sequence, diverges. N equals 2, infinity, an equals infinity, this diverges. So, the sum n equals 2 to infinity of bn, this sequence that we care about, is the sum from n equals 2 to infinity. These bn's, this diverges also. So what happened in this problem is we thought first about trying to understand the series using the integral test. We got stuck with an integral we didn't know how to do. So we wanted to try something else. We compare 1 over natural log of n to 1 over n, a sequence that we know well. That series that we get from that sequence is a p series with p equals 1, so it diverges. And because the smaller series diverges, the comparison test says the bigger series diverges as well.